Alrighty, welcome everybody to the Virtual Trunking Protocol Lab. Now, why do we need VTP? VTP takes a look at our VLANs and passes them on through to our switch network. Alright, with VTP, we should create a domain name. That way, everybody's in the same domain. They'll pass on the information. When you create a VLAN, it'll pass all to the other switches as well. Okay, it maintains the naming convention. It looks, does the frame tag, it does everything they need to know. One screen that you need to be familiar with, and I'll click here on this switch. One screen that you need to be familiar with for your certification purposes is show VTP stat. Okay, show VTP stat. What's important about here? It's the revision number. The revision number, and see if you have a domain name and if you're a server, but mainly the revision number. The higher the revision number, means that switch has the latest information and will send out everything it has in its VLAN database to all the other switches. Obviously, we have server, right, as a mode by default, and we have client as a mode by default. All right, transparent is what I call the greedy one because it doesn't accept any updates from server client. Doesn't accept it. It just sees it and just passes it on through. It will not update its own VLAN database with anybody else's information. Period. And it will not share its VLAN database with anybody else's information. So VTP is extremely important. And one of the other things that you will be needing to look at and understand is this down here. Because you need to understand who just last modified you. So when we start doing this configuration, which we will, all right, we're going to go ahead and put IP addresses on there like it was for VLAN 1, all right, because everybody's part of VLAN 1, as you can see, show VLAN brief, all right, we're all part of VLAN 1. So we're going to create an IP scheme for VLAN 1, which is just the 192.168.1.0/24, just make it simple, okay? So what do we need to configure? Well, first of all, let's configure some VLANs. Let's just configure two VLANs. Very simple. Well, first, let's give it a name. Config T, host name. We'll call this core switch. Put in caps. Core SW. Okay. Now we're going to create some VLANs. Very difficult to do. VLAN 10. Name, and I was, well, let's put accounting, let's do something different. VLAN 20, name, warehouse. I used to work at a warehouse, so I want to be in the mix. Name, warehouse. All right, we'll do a do WR. You can't do that in the certification. You have to go ahead and go back to publish mode and do copy run start. You can do the do when you get to your job or in your job. Do show VLAN brief. All right. So there are the VLANs. I'm not going to assign them to the core switch. I'm just creating them there. So what do we do? We're going to go to VTP. Well, first of all, we're going to create a VTP domain name. VTP domain, and we'll call it Cisco. Okay. You see, it switched from nothing to Cisco. That's what that message means. All right. And we take a look at that. VTP, show VTP stat. Do show VTP stat. All right, there you can see that now we have the domain name Cisco. Now, it's also a good idea to put in a password, VTP password, because if you just have a VTP domain name, anybody can just plug in and still get the information. So you, but the passwords need to be manual. They need to be manual. All right, so we configure a VLAN, we did VTP. All right, now we're going to trunk the ports. Which ports we need to trunk? Ports 22 and 23. How do I know? Because if you look at the topology, 22 and, well, it says 24. Let's disconnect that. 24, well, I always put it towards the router. Oh, no, it was the name. Silly name. All right, let's get a crossover cable. Port 23 to port 23. And that's the reason why I do that, because that way I can create a range. Let's do fast forward 3 times. And you can see there's a root bridge, but that's another video. Okay? All right, so 2022-23, that's all we're going to trunk. So we're going to do int range f0/22-23 switch port mode trunk. Now listen, this is a layer 2 switch. This is not a layer 3 switch. So you ain't got to go through all, tell it what trunking protocol you want. It's going to use 802.1q. How can we see that? All right, I'm going to do a WR here, but you cannot do it in the test. All right, and do show in trunk. All right, you can see 802.1q is on. It's on. So we have the trunking that's actually turned on. So while we're here, since we talked about an IP scheme, let's go ahead and put one. Config t, int VLAN 1, interface, VLAN 1, IP address, 192.168.1.255.255.0. And then we need to no shut it. We need to turn it on. All right. But now, why did I put 253? Because our gateway IP default gateway is 192.168.1.254, which is going to be the router. You're over to plug one in, all right? So, we're done there. The W, okay? Now we go down to these two switches down here. This will be the accounting. This will be the warehouse, all right? And we'll name them as such so we know where we're at. Okay, again, there you go. I can go ahead and do that. All right, enable config T, host name, and ACCT. First thing, we want to change it to client. The reason we want to change it to client is so they don't have to, nobody can mess with the VLAN database. All right, so we can do VTP mode client. All right, let's see if the VLANs came down. Do show VLAN brief. Yes, VLAN brief. All right, and there they are. So that's great. VTP is the one that does that. All right, they allowed it because one, they're trunk ports, okay, so they'll mirror each other. Two, VTP is watching these VLANs, so it's going to let them disseminate down because we're going to be part of the same domain. Last, how do you know we're part of the same domain? Well, we'll do show VTP sat. And there we are, Cisco. Okay, but remember, clients accept updates, not only send them, but they update them. Okay, all right. So now these, let's do show VLAN brief again. Do show VLAN brief. So these VLANs now get to be assigned. So this is the accounting switch. So we're gonna assign them. Now, we can't assign them. We're not going to because the whole point is to do the VTP. Is to do the VTP. Well, let's put in the IP address. All right. So we're gonna do int VLAN 1 IP address. 192.168.1.252.255. Wow. Fingers don't want to work. 255.255.0. And then we do a no shut. And then we do an exit out of here. And in global configuration, you're going to do IP default hyphen gateway 192.168.1.254. Remember, this is about VLAN 1. VLAN 1, all right? So the port to trunk, if you do show in trunk, automatically, okay? Because that's the default setting for the port anyway, but you can see it's trunk. You don't have a problem for VLAN 1, all right? So that's it, and we saw the VLANs over there. We saw the VTP, so we're good. We're just worrying about VTP, all right? That screen that I want you to see. Let's go to CLI first. Maximize. This is the warehouse. All right, config T. Host name, warehouse. Okay, so there's the warehouse. So what we're going to do is change our client, VTP mode client. Okay, so that's a client. Do show VLAN brief. See how the VLANs come down? It's awesome. This is awesome. It cuts your work in half. All right. And then we go to accounting. I mean, warehouse. We're going to int range. I always use the same range. F0/22-23. Switch port mode trunk. All right? Yeah, get it out of the way. All right? Gonna exit. Going to the VLAN IP address. Int VLAN 1. They won't check. IP address 192.168.251. We got 253, 252, 251, 255. All right, work this time. 255.255.0. Enter. What did I do incorrectly? Oh, okay. 192.168.1.251. There we go. No shot. See, when you get that little carrot symbol, just say, hey, you made a mistake here, fix it. Okay, done deal. All right, and then we do the default gateway. IP default hyphen gateway 192.168.1.254. That's it. So the screen that we're concerned with is show BTP stat. This is the one you need to be worried about, because you need to make sure that, hey, something happened, who modified me. This is the one. Okay, you're gonna see the IP address here. So to prove that, let's go ahead and go into the switch and let's add a VLAN. Let's do a VLAN 100, and then we'll say name wireless, right? The WR. Okay, let's see what happened. Let's go down to this switch over here. Do a no barrel. And you see that number incremented to the amount of VLANs, okay? And look, you just got modified by the root bridge. So this is an important screen, especially for your certification. If they ask you, hey, who was the last switch that modified you? You do a show BTP stat, and that's it. And you can see who. Now, if they ask for a name, obviously, you do show CDP neighbor detail, not just show CDP neighbor. You do show CDP neighbor detail. You saw it was the 253 that went ahead and modified you. Well, it's not the accounting switch that modified me. Okay. Oh, here it is up here. Missed it. It's the 253, which is the core switch. Now you got the name as well. So you see how simple that is? That is what BTP does. It maintains the naming convention. It allows VLANs to trickle down. You create domains within BTP, right? That way it's a means of security. But if you want to go deeper, right, and learn how to work with it in a full network, I urge you to please go to globed.net and look at the courses there, the complete course, which is there for the CCNA and other courses that you can browse at your leisure, okay, and you can, you know, get them, because you need to get certified this year. So all the details, right, that I get into are there, okay? Plus, I'm going to be running boot camps and stuff like that. So just take a look at globed.net and see what you like best, and then download them. Download them, you know, purchase them, download them, and it'll get into the details that you need. All right, for the CCNA. I hope you like this this video. And if you did, please like and subscribe. See you in the next one.